What's up guys, S-52 and welcome back to another deck review. On today's edition, we have got the Red Knights by Ellusionist, Daniel Madison and Chris Ramsay. So without further ado, let's get into it. This is the Red Knights by Ellusionist, Daniel Madison and Chris Ramsay, which is the second installment in the Knights campaign that they were doing when they were both at Ellusionist. Like in the first edition, this has been fully designed by Oban Jones, who is one of the main creators down at Ellusionist, and he's had full artistic design with the two guys over this deck. According to the Ellusionist website, the Knight is the most devastating piece on the chessboard and is the most unpredictable as it can jump out of any situation over any of the pieces. So, without further ado, let's get into this deck review. So the tuck case itself is a red matte case with gold foil printing. Now, you've got on the top, it's got the words Knights. You've got the chess pieces down the back even. You have Madison and Ramsay downside, which is an addition to the series this time compared to the last one where it didn't have that gold foil on. And the front, it just has the standard knight symbol with the blade in the middle as compared to the first edition where we had the word Knight, Madison and Ramsay written on there. As we pop the tuck case lid open, we have this gold foil around the outside and that continues inside with this checkerboard piece there with a chess piece that goes fully into the deck inside the tuck case, which is beautiful in this light. And we have Oban Jones's symbol just there at the bottom of the knight. This comes with two sets of jokers, unlike any other playing card series. You have the Oban Jones designed joker, which has Charlie Madison on there, which I assume is Charlie Madison, and you have two other ones which have Chris Ramsay and Daniel Madison as their playing cards on there as well with a hidden reveal, so that's quite nice. The cards are a crushed stock, traditionally cut, and they have red foil on the back design. Now it is worth noting that with this deck it does not come in new deck order, but rather it comes one perfect pharaoh shuffle away from Mnemonica, which is obviously Juan Tamariz's famous stack that he uses. The back design is a bunch of random chess pieces, but there is two hidden things in the red one. We have a mark system for number, and we also have a little symbol at the top that dictates the suit, which means that these are a fully marked deck if you can read them quick enough. The back design is a non-direct border, which means that it is not 100% bordered all the way around. It has that absence of white in the middle, which is quite nice when it comes through the deck. Now, like with most decks, there is customization on the court card. So we have Daniel Madison as the King of Diamonds. We have David Blaine as the King of Spades, Chris Ramsay as the King of Hearts, and Bobby Fischer as the King of Clubs, and Oban Jones taking the Jack of Clubs. As well as that, you will be getting a customized Ace of Spades like most decks. This has a giant feature piece on the front with the words Madison, Ramsay, and a Red Knight logo at the top. Unlike the first edition, there has been a swap in the court cards between Chris Ramsay and David Blaine. I don't know why, but I think David Blaine, he released the split spades So I assume that potentially he is the King of Spades and that's why they swapped them over. When I went up to Leeds at the first Daniel Madison meetup, we were asking about the night series, and one of the things he did say is that there were much more plans for the night series. It just the brand just never really took off, and it only really took off when they left Ellusionist, him and Chris. And as we have seen, Christmas just gone in December, they released two new colours of the night. So we've got the green and we've got a blue version, and I imagine Ellusionist is probably going to milk it for more, and we're going to see a lot more of that series coming out. The pips of the deck are pretty much standard as most. So for the black, they will be like any other that you see. And for the red, you have black ink on the top two corners that denote the number or the letter of the card. And each of the symbols, including the little pips, have a black outline around there, which I think just gives it a very sort of almost cartoony vibe, but I like it. I think it's a very good vibe on the deck. So everyone always asks, how do the knights feel? And I have to say that these are one of the best Ellusionist decks that I have had to date. In comparison to the white knights, they are thinner in stock, which means that they spring, I think, better. They have better handling and quality, and that's definitely a trait that I do love about them. So let's get into the review. I'm gonna give these a 10 out of 13. I'm gonna give these an 11 out of 13 because they are dope. I've had these since April and I've used them quite a while. I would definitely say that these are quite good. So I'm gonna give these a 10 out of 13. In terms of the marking system, unless you can remember it and you are a wizard, I don't think the marking system is that practical. So I'm gonna give that a 9 out of 13, purely because I think it's ingenious but hard to read. Which, if I'm not mistaken, that gives these a grand total of 40 out of 52. Anyway guys, I hope that you enjoyed that review. If there are any other cards that you would like to see, or you have cards that you would like to be reviewed, send them my way. DM me on Instagram and I will review them for you. If you enjoyed this video, make sure that you like, you subscribe and you comment down below. And as always, head over to my Instagram and check me out there. Links in the description. That's it for today, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye!